I'm going to talk about achromatic polarization wave plates, how to create achromatic polarization wave plates using standard wave plates. For this talk, I will need composite pulses in quantum mechanics. And then we will make the analogy between the quantum mechanics of two quantum states with the polarization optics, and then take the well-known composite pulses from quantum mechanics and apply it in polarization optics to make achromatic polarization wave plates. Let's start with two-state system. We can be in a ground state or an excited state. It could be a two-level atom. And the wave function is superposition of a ground state and excited state. We can write the Schrödinger equation for C1 and C2 for the coefficients, and it looks like this, where delta is the detuning, which is the difference between the laser frequency and the frequency that corresponds to energy transfer between state 1 and state 2. It's called the detuning. And the other element is the Rabi frequency, which is proportional to dipole moment of transition from ground state to excited state and the electric field. On the case of exact resonance, when the laser field is equal to the frequency of the laser fluid is equal to the frequency of the transfer between ground and excited state, then delta is zero and it's resonant. The solutions are for these differential equations are easily solved. It's a linear system of two differential equations, and it's given as a evaluation matrix, the propagator. And the propagator consists of only one element, so it's cosine, cosine, minus I sine, minus I sine of so-called pulse error, which is the integral of Rabi frequency over the time. So the evaluation matrix connects the initial states with the final states. So if we know the initial states in the evaluation matrix, we can find the final states. The problem here on exact resonance is that if we start from a ground state and want to transfer all population in the excited state, then it's done only for the pulse error, which is exactly pi. If it's not pi, then some of the probability to find the state in the ground state is here, and it's not 100% probability to be the excited state. If it's the pulse error is pi, then it's 100%, everything is excited over here. So what's the idea, how to make a technique that is more robust with respect to the pulse area and tolerate the difference in the pulse area not to be only pi? Okay, so let's examine again the resonant case, but now let's put the Rabi frequency a phase. So we assume the Rabi frequency is no longer real, but it's a complex value. And let's assume that we have a good control of the phase. The evolution matrix is written in this way. So we have some extra terms compared to the previous solution over here. And again, this is the pulse area. Now, instead of one pulse, we can think that we shine the laser, turn it off, shine the laser, turn it off. So it's a sequence of n pulses. Every pulse with a different pulse area and different phase. So the whole propagator, after n pulses, the propagator of the system is just a product of each pulse. Now, if you assume that each pulse have almost the same pulse area, that we cannot control very good, but we have a good control over the phase, then we can make this is a matrix, but all four elements in the matrix depends from the pulse area, so we can make a Taylor's expansion around a point, a given point. So make a Taylor expansion of the four elements. So look like this. And if all derivatives are zero, then it's independent from the pulse area. And in practice it's not like this, so it depends from the pulse area. So what we can do is we can fix the zero element, the zero derivative, which is our matrix, the target matrix that we want, to fix it to the desired value and fix derivative, the first derivative is zero, fix the second derivative zero, third derivative zero, and so on. So if we have the freedom to choose the phases, we choose the phases in such a way that they satisfy this system of derivatives. For example, if we have three phases, we can fix with one, we can fix the zero derivative, with the second we can fix the first derivative, and with the third we can fix the second derivative. So it means we can fix the second and the first derivative to be zero, and then we have desired value and the dependence of both areas start from third order, which means it's not so sensitive to the deviation of the pulse over. If you have more free parameters, then we can nullify more terms, and then we are more robust with respect to variation in the pulse area. This is the idea of composite pulses. Let's see how we can transfer them in polarization optics. Now, polarization optics. In polarization optics, we can write everything in the Poincaré sphere. Any polarization states can be represented on the Poincaré sphere, where the linear polarization are our equator, right and left circle polarization are on the south and north pole, and any elliptical polarization is between the poles and the equator. If you're closer to the poles, then you're closer to the circle polarization. If you're closer to the equator, then you're closer to linear polarization. Here is horizontal, 45 degrees, vertical, minus 45 degrees, and any other. And there are two main optical elements. One is called rotator, which rotates in this direction. So if you are over here and it rotates parallel to the equator, it's called rotator. And the other element rotates on the other axis, from the equator to the poles. It's called retarder. Mathematically, we can write rotator and retarder with the John matrices. This is the John matrix of rotator, which is matrix of rotation, and retarder looks like this. There are two main types of most useful wave plates. It's called half wave plate when retardation is pi, and quarter wave plate when the retardation is pi over 2. And this is the retarder written when the fast and the slow axis of retarder are coincide with the horizontal and vertical axis. If they are rotated with respect to some angle with horizontal and vertical axis, angle theta, then it is the John matrix of retarder rotated on this angle. We can write it in, this is written in so-called horizontal vertical basis, but we can write it, the retarder, in the left-right circle polarization basis, which is more convenient somehow. In the left-right circle polarization basis, the John matrix of retarder looks like this, where angle of rotation of the wave plate is theta and the retardation is phi. So let's compare this evolution matrix, which is the Jones matrix polarization, with the evolution matrix in the two-state quantum system. This is the two-state quantum system that we used before, and this is the polarization, the retarder in the right-left circle polarization basis, rotated in angle theta. So it corresponds to one-to-one to two-state quantum system, where the pulse area here is given by retardation, and the phase here is 2 times the angle of rotation. So we can apply the composite pulses from nuclear magnetic resonance. Now, instead of pulses, we have wave plates, and we can have n wave plates. In each wave plate, we can rotate the angle of rotation in such a way that we nullify some derivatives. If we have 3 wave plates, then we can derive nullify 3 derivatives. If you have more wave plates, then we can nullify more derivative. So this is how the theory looks like. This is the pulse area. If you have in units of pi, if you have pi, then you have complete population transfer from horizontal, you go to vertical. But if you for a single wave plate, but if your pulse area or the retardation is not pi, then you have something in between. But if you start to nullify derivative over here, you make a bigger and bigger plateau. If you have more derivative, the plateau is bigger and bigger. It means less sensitive to the variation in the pulse area. So how this is look like in experimentally, here is an example, experimental example. This is half wave plate, which works as a half wave plate about 780 nanometers. But if you take it for different wavelengths, this is no longer half wave plate. Doesn't give you from horizontal, doesn't give you vertical polarization. But if you combine five elements and choose the angle of rotation to unify four derivatives, then you see it start to be a broadband. It's in the area of between 600 nanometers and 1200 nanometers. It's almost not change. So it's a broadband, achromatic, or whatever you call it, wave plate. With that, thank you for the attention.